I win again.
You are too expert for the others, dear.
Eh? What? What? Oh, yes, yes. The game bores me.
Magnificently played, Your Majesty. But I say, Your Majesty has awful.
Your Majesty, you sent for me. What is your wish?
Eh? Wish? What did I wish?
Your Colonel of Hussars has been slack in his duties.
Oh, yes, yes. Colonel, you've been slack in your duty.
Your Majesty, I...
Silence! The Queen says you've been slack in your duties. What hasn't he done this time?
When I was out driving, there was a rabble of beggars on the highway. The Colonel's Hussars did not disperse them quickly enough.
And why did your Hussars delay, sir?
I crave your indulgence, sire. I was fearful of causing a riot. Day by day, the people are becoming more vicious. Nearer an armed revolt.
What? Revolt?
Them are starving, Your Majesty. They have no bread.
If they have no bread, then let them eat cake.
Yes, well, why don't they eat cake?
Your Majesty, I really am worried.
Colonel is always worrying about something, Your Majesty.
Yes, my dear Kazan. When he worries, he's serious. And when he's serious, he's funny. Well, when you are serious, you are funny. You amuse me.
The hour draws near. Prepare. France must rise as one man and one woman in defense of her very life. Have we the blood of snails in our veins that we must combat suffering by bearing greater suffering, hunger and starvation? The fear of death is in the eyes of all France. Old men who have fought and bled for the king and country lie dying in filth and despair. Our mothers, our children are begging for bread. His lashes upon our backs, cutting, cutting, searing the flesh of all France. And shall we die like hunted rabbits, like sheep, bleeding for mercy where there is no mercy? Patriots, France must be free. Down with the aristocrats, liberty or death.
Enough. You won't leave this room until we settle this marriage.
You settle it. I'm busy.
I never should have taken you to Paris. You haven't been the same since.
Yes. I've always dreamed of meeting a man like that.
But you didn't meet him. He didn't even see. He doesn't know you're alive.
Yes, poor fellow.
And you're going to forget him. You're going to marry him again at the town.
I can remember perfectly how his eyes looked.
And on his wrist.
And his silver buckles as they twinkled in the sun. And his nose. It was magnificent.
Eyes? Buckles? Nose? Nonsense. You're going to marry Bazin.
Bazin? He's old enough to be my father.
What difference does that make?
No difference to you. You don't have to marry him.
Surely you must see that I know what is better for your happiness. He is in the king's service.
Secret service? A spy?
Well, men in that line of work are received by the king. He is practically an aristocrat.
I think he's... Oh.
I'm only trying to better your position in the world, my dear.
I know, Papa, but I'm not very much interested in position in the world. And anyway, I want to marry a man I love.
Yes, coming.
I was told this is the inn.
Yes.
I'm Rouget de Lille.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. Right this way, sir.
I beg your pardon. I'll have to ask you to wait just a moment, sir. I forgot to tell my daughter about you. She's rather nervous. She's nervous, sir.
Marie, my dear.
Yes, Papa, who was it?
I have a surprise for you.
What?
You see, the ladies of Paris are learning to play and sing very prettily. It's very fashionable.
What is this?
Why, we sent for a music teacher. He's come. Bazin thought that,
Bazin?
Yeah, he thought that,
He thought, did he? He thought he could make a lady out of me.
No, yes.
Well, I don't want to be a lady.
Marie, my dear, Marie.
So you can tell your singing teacher to take his songbook and go on back to Paris.
Oh, but Marie...
I don't even want to...
The music teacher.
I think, sir, you'd better start in at once, sir. Excuse me.
Won't you allow me, please? Anxious to hear your voice, mademoiselle. Will you be so kind?
With pleasure.
Long that I see in his
Did you like it?
I think you're wonderful. I mean that you really have a very lovely voice. Of course, you need personal supervision, personal guidance, many lessons. For example, the little song you have just sung, in the last two lines, should flow more on the breath, like a sigh. Can it be? It is. Love.
Why, of course.
Yes, that's it. No, don't mistake me. What I mean to say is, when the breath flows, it should come more from...
Hurry, boys, let's change horses.
Welcome to our humble house.
Good afternoon, Monet.
Yes, sir.
I think it best to have the marriage contract drawn immediately. Before I change my mind.
There is no hurry.
When you're as old as I am, there's no time to lose.
Yes, but I must tell you, Marie does not entirely agree with our arrangement.
What do you mean?
She says she doesn't love you.
Are you a fool, Marnay? Call the notary. Have the contract drawn. We'll be married. Then leave the rest to me. To the bride, Marnay. And to your new son-in-law.
Place your hands on the keyboard.
Thank you. was made. Love had you just in view. Each bird sings a love serenade. All for you, for is true. Love through every flower for you. I measured each hour for you. God painted the dawn. Each sunset was drawn in a heaven's deep blue. For you, only you. One heart beats alone. For you, one dream of a home for two, dear, has changed all the world to a love rendezvous, where life is all love.
Return to help us celebrate.
You seem to be very sure there's cause to celebrate.
Cause? Naturally. My Maria is to be the lady of a king's officer.
Which is preferable, I suppose, to being the lady of a king's counselor.
But, sir, you must not begrudge young love happiness. I've always favored the military. I'd join the king's service myself if I were younger.
As a lackey, perhaps.
You are not generous. Surely you can't blame the girl for her choice. He is handsome and young, a fine figure. You will wait and drink with us?
No.
May I send you some old burgundy as a remembrance of the day?
I shall not forget the day. Nor will you, my friend.
And think, Joseph, they're celebrating for us. Isn't it wonderful?
Wonderful? When I must leave you tonight, to be gone for a year.
Let's not think of it. Let's think of the honor. A captain in the king's hussars.
If I had my choice, I...
Shh. Your first duty is to your king and to your country.
I know.
And my captain will be back in a year.
And nothing shall ever part us again.
Nothing.
Gentlemen, attention. I present to you our new comrade, descendant of an illustrious line of gallant fighting men, Captain Claude Joseph Rouget de Lille. Health and renown of Captain Rouget de Lille.
May His Majesty ever be right, but right or wrong, His Majesty.
That is meant for men. It's your fault. steady and true. A flaming shield at night, an arm of might that never comes back on God. It's a fund, it's a fund. Only comrades that gold cannot buy. And though you're in the fun, all in the might is ready.
By the day, by the hour, new followers are joining the force. Soon we shall have arms and ammunition brought by the battalion from Marseilles. The hour is approaching, the supreme hour for Frenchmen.
Death to all who refuse to take the oath of independence. The birth of a new republic is at hand. Soon the aristocrats, with their powdered wigs, their silk stockings, will run like stag before the hounds. With one voice, the people will shout, on to the gates of the Tuileries. Open in the name of the people. Our guns will spit. The blood of the aristocrats will flood the streets. And France will be free.
Forefathers have fought for the kings of France. Now you ask me to fight again.
Where do you stand? For us? Or for the king?
For France and for the king.
A fool.
Give me my bill.
Why, there is no bill. You are my guest.
We do not accept favors from the enemy. There.
never mind them, Papa. You mustn't be distressed because they call you royalist. Why, that's an honor for a village innkeeper. Am I not a royalist? And Claude Joseph, is he not a royalist? Drink. Drink to the royal family. Oh, come now, Papa. France will be happy again. Remember, my Claude Joseph is now close to the king. He'll make his majesty understand. Oh, come now, smile for me.
She's yours, do you?
She is. Aren't you, little one?
Stop! Stop! Fools! Killing yourselves over a village wench? Put up your swords. Decide with dice, like gentlemen.
That's a good idea.
And go ahead. I'll hold the stakes.
You can do better than that.
Now, do I get the girl?
Take her if you like.
Leave the girl alone. Keep your hands off her. Thieves. Thieves. Get out of my house.
We'll take no curses from your filthy kind. We wear the king's uniform.
The king's uniform. Why, you're not fit to wear the nose ring of the
the pigsty. You're a disgrace. A disgrace to the uniform of France.
To arms. But where are the arms? Where are they? I'll tell you. Locked safely in the arsenal of the king. Dare we risk the fate of France on axes, hay rakes, and pikes? No!
They're right. We must not attack.
Don't worry, we won't attack. The torch will soon be here, and when she speaks, they'll listen.
There's one matter on which he has no compliments for you, nor any of his confidential agents.
Indeed.
But haven't I obtained the evidence you asked in every instance?
Some days ago, I spoke to you about a mob leader called the Torch.
Quite so. A girl, I believe you said. I wondered how a girl could lead that crowd of snarling dogs.
Have you forgotten one girl who made history for France?
Surely you're not comparing this girl of the mob to Joan of Arc.
Oh, I am not, sir. She's no leader. She has no call from God. But she moves among them like the shadow of revolution and of treason. She makes no speeches, but she's talking. She's always talking.
And they listen?
Frenchmen demand a symbol, an ideal, even the mob.
Yes?
She has already become that ideal. She symbolizes freedom.
Well, in that case, Colonel, the king will take great pleasure in learning of her arrest.
Arrest?
You think I've been asleep, sir? At any moment, I expect to hear her name and hiding place.
every flower for you. I measured each hour for you. What painted the dawn? Each sunset was drawn in heaven's deep blue for you. Only you. One heart beats alone for you. One dream of a home for two, dear, has changed all the world to a love rendezvous. For you, just you.
Of you and me. That is all you must become.
I know, Pierre.
Your father. The sufferings of our people. France. Is it not bigger? Greater than any love? You mean so much to the cause. You have become the... a symbol for freedom. Must forget.
Come, Pierre, let us go. They are waiting. Leader, I'm only one of you. Citizens, we must wait. Wait till we've found a way to rouse the men of Marseille, to give them spirit. Spirit to fight for freedom. Lose faith. We must not lose courage. But we must not attack. We must wait. Wait and carry on.
Ye carry on, sir.
and wretched of night. Oh, here is he who brings the light. It takes a spark to light the flame deep in your eyes. In freedom's name. On, carry on, while you hold on high your flames of victory. Now on, carry on, while your country's in the hour of need. Carry on, while your gorgeous flame. Carry on, in your country's name. With pride and her fire, and with blood and with fire. Wreak vengeance, sire, that France be free.
Find it delightful?
Delightful, my dear.
Delightful,
delightful, oh, your Majesty. And you, my dear?
Delightful, your Majesty. Delightful.
Captain Rouget de Lille, I am about
send you on a dangerous mission, one that demands the utmost secrecy.
You honor me, sir.
You know the village of St. Cloud?
I once lived there, sir.
Good. You will proceed there immediately to a tavern called the Cork Door, now completely deserted.
Yes, sir.
At that tavern, you will be joined by Monsieur Bazin and a company of picked men.
Yes, sir.
I shall expect you to cooperate with Monsieur Bazin and to carry out his orders exactly as if they were my own.
I understand, sir.
And the captain.
You will undertake this mission dressed as a citizen, not an officer.
That's all, Captain. Except good fortune and Godspeed. Monsieur Bazin, your insistence that this secret mission be entrusted to an officer of my regiment is a great honor.
Each hour for you, God painted the dawn, each sunset was drawn in a... only you. One heart beats alone for you, one dream of a home. Are too dear, a season of the world, one love rendezvous, where life is all love for you.
Splendid, my dear Captain, splendid.
Bazin!
Allow me to offer you congratulations, Captain. You have succeeded in your mission, even before I arrived.
But I...
Perhaps I forgot to tell you. Your mission was to capture the torch. The king's enemy, condemned to die for treason. Marie Marnay.
Marie? I don't believe it.
It's true, Joseph.
Take her away.
Stop. Take your hands off.
Captain!
You planned this, persuaded my colonel to send me here, tricked me.
You swine.
Joseph!
Tell them to let her go. Tell them. Do you hear me? Tell them.
Let me go. Let me go.
Marie!
It is futile. Your pleadings for the girl are eloquent. But
I implore your graceful leniency. I beg you for her life.
I must say, Captain, you seem to be strangely interested in this girl.
Your grace, I...
Perhaps I can explain, Your Grace.
Oh.
This woman, I believe, was the captain's mistress.
You swine! Your Grace, we were engaged to marry.
So, a captain of the King's Hussars was engaged to marry a village wench. A traitor to the King. A leader in the revolution.
She was not their leader. She was only their friend. A friend who nursed their sick, prayed for them, bound their wounds.
She roused them to treason.
As my men testified at her trial, she was heard to curse the king.
You lie.
Captain Roger de Lille, this is treason.
Treason. By begging for that girl's life, I was never more loyal.
Be careful.
Careful? I be careful? Listen to the voice of the people. Can't you realize what will happen if you destroy their friend, their saint? They came here to beg for mercy, to plead for the life of one they love. Are they slaves that they must starve, die to serve a king's desire? Their sufferings have gone too far. Remember, Your Grace, they're Frenchmen.
Captain Roger de Lille, in the name of the king, I arrest you.
Arrest her. Arrest her. Hang us. But that won't save the king.
Silence!
You won't listen. Fool! France will make you listen. Freedom will find a voice.
Keep
silence!
Now what shall we do?
I have a surprise for you.
A surprise?
You remember Rouget de Lisle, your captain of hussars, who sang so divinely when we gave our little play last April?
Yes. But what's the surprise?
He has written a new song, which he is going to sing for you.
How can he sing it? He's in prison. No, maybe he isn't in prison. Maybe they've hanged him already.
Had him released. And he is going to sing for you, and you are going to pardon him. Aren't you, dear?
Yes. He's going to sing for me, and I'm going to pardon him. Yes, of course. Will someone remind me that I'm going to pardon him?
I will, Your Majesty.
Captain Rouget de Lisle.
Captain de Lisle.
Well, proceed. Your song pleases me. I will permit you to dedicate it to me, Captain.
It has already been dedicated, sire.
Eh?
To France.
Eh, France? I am France, Captain. Proceed.
France with luxury around, now hear the death cry of your reign. Your thirst for gold and poppy is unfounded, so to right has come to steal your name. Hark to the cries of the ones filled with gold. No longer shall we shoulder the load, for each man of France has found freedom's goal. For man is man, and who is more? And our peace and liberty is bleeding. France, to arms you bring, avenging sword and shield.
I don't like this world.
It's better than grave.
City is very quiet. I knew the people never would dare to attack the king's soldiers.
Oh, when they hang her, the revolution is ended.
Why, there never was a revolution.
Ah, but if the bells had rung.
What bells?
Didn't you hear of the meeting at the Rue du Bac? Former king's officer, Rouget de Lisle, was sent to Marseilles to bring back men and ammunition.
Well, where are they?
Yes. They should have been here 2 days ago. The bells of the city were to ring at daybreak as a signal for their arrival. Then all Paris was to attack.
That was 2 days ago. The bells won't ring now.
Well, come. We must finish so they can hang her.
I'm going to pray.
I will pray for her, too.
worrying about? You're always worrying.
I'm worrying about that mob of Paris. Why are they so quiet? They know the girl is about to hang. Why do they do nothing? They are planning something.
Oh, my dear Colonel. They wouldn't dare attack the king's soldiers.
Huh? Perhaps.
That is all we of this earth can do for you, my child. My child, I
it may comfort you to know that your work amongst the people is being carried on. There are whispers of a young man and a song.
Joseph!
Perhaps I have spoken treason, but... child, I shall not see you again until